Did you know an asteroid recently missed colliding with us here on Earth? I didn't. A space rock as big as a 10-story building with a speed of 9.9 miles per second could have crashed into us, but slipped past at the very last moment. To talk more about that, we're joined now by Eric Edelman, an astronomer from SLU Observatory. Eric, as far as I know, asteroids pass by very close to Earth on almost a daily basis. Why is this one making headlines?
This one is a bit of a surprise to us. I think that's the reason why so many people are talking about it, because we did discover this asteroid. The first time we observed this asteroid with telescopes was on the 7th of this month. And when it passed closer to us than the moon, that was 2 days later. That was its close approach on the 9th. So 2 days pass, and then it has its close approach. That's not a lot of time. Mm. At least, you know, sort of to my mind, it brings up, you know, the sort of a similar scenario of someone all of a sudden breathing down the back of your neck. You didn't realize they were creeping up behind you, but all of a sudden they are right there. And it's the same sort of feeling, like we have this asteroid that's just immediately right there. There's not a lot of time to do much about it. Luckily enough, this one wasn't heading directly for us this time, but it sort of exposes sort of a vulnerability that we have, a little bit of a blind spot that sometimes we don't see them until they are right nearby, and the potential that can mean for us in terms of preparing for anything that is on a collision course for us maybe is why this one's being talked about a little bit more than others.
You said it was closer to us than the moon. Can you describe exactly how close it was, give viewers some perspective?
Oh, absolutely. So the moon is on average about 240,000 miles away from us. Cut that one in about half. So this one's about 120,000 miles away when it made its absolute closest approach. So this is amazing, because most things in astronomy are not really digestible on a human scale, though I would say 120,000 miles is. Maybe somebody has driven that far in their car over the course of a number of years. But anything really beyond the moon, when we're talking about those distances, we're talking in terms of tens or hundreds of millions of miles, unfathomable distances on a human scale. Mm. So the fact that we can comprehend this number, that in itself is just tells us how much closer this gets than a lot of other things out there in space.
Can you talk about how concerned astronomers are about the potential future collision with an asteroid, if that's a risk we should be taking seriously? And then also, you know, what would happen if an asteroid of that size ever did hit the Earth?
So this is a big conversation that I think a lot of astronomers are having right now in both private and public organizations alike. We have NASA that's working tirelessly to try and identify and track as many of these asteroids as possible. We have organizations like B612, private organizations by the ex-astronaut Ed Liu. He founded that one. They're trying to work toward making solutions for tracking these asteroids as well. It's a very big conversation, because it is something that has a potential there, not a huge potential for worldly destruction, really. We have most of the asteroids that are sort of an apocalyptic size. We know where they are, we know where they're going, and that's pretty good. But we're still working on finding some of the smaller ones, like this asteroid, which, if it, say, were to collide with us, there are a lot of variables involved, including, you know, where exactly it was colliding on Earth, what the angle of impact was, what it's composed of. But in terms of its speed and size, it's sort of comparable to the sort of issue that happened over Chelyabinsk with that meteor a couple of years back, where it exploded in midair. It didn't actually reach the ground. But even so, the shockwave from that explosion being as powerful as the Hiroshima bomb 10 times over, tens of times over, this shockwave, it reached the ground and sort of messed with a lot of infrastructure there. The most injuries coming out of that, there were over 1,000 injuries from that explosion, were because of some of the shattered glass that was affecting, was hurting people there. So even when an asteroid doesn't actually reach the ground, it can still mean bad news for people in the local region. So even though it may not destroy our entire planet, it's still something that a lot of people are concerned about in terms of it catching us unawares and harming our populations.
This is one of the most fascinating things to me about space, because it because something that can directly impact us right here on Earth. So I could talk to you more about it. We're unfortunately out of time, but I'd love to bring you back, talk to you more about asteroids and everything that's going on up there in space. Eric Edelman, SLU astronomer, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks.